Chào, tên của con là Long.
Hi, jeg heter Long.
Hi, my name is Long.
So you can tell I'm bilingual. In this case, I can understand and speak Vietnamese mostly and English pretty fluently. And with this ongoing pandemic that's going on right now, I'm starting to learn Norwegian. And let me tell you, learning a new language in your 20s is hard. It's really hard. So you're probably wondering, why do I care if you're bilingual? What's this got to do with me? And let me tell you, learning Norwegian really put things into perspective for me. But first, I gotta explain how bilingualism works. So when you're bilingual, in this case, Vietnamese and English, I can automatically process those words and know what it means like that. But now that I'm learning Norwegian, I need to actually translate each word from Norwegian to English back to Norwegian, or English, Norwegian, just to make sure I'm getting the right word. So to demonstrate what I mean about automatic processes, I'm gonna use the phrase, what are you talking about? And obviously in English, what are you talking about? In Vietnamese, might not give I. And then in Norwegian, that's, or Norsk, that's going to be, what are, what are you talking? Vas naka du om. You saw, when I was trying to speak Norwegian, I had to kind of pause and translate the word over and then translate back over. And yeah, so basically learning a new language really helped me understand more of what it is to be like bilingual, obviously having automatic processes and not consciously thinking of actually translating each word over, right? So yeah, this is like a little mini video explaining what it's like to be bilingual, and I mean, that's about it. So you're probably wondering why a person like me living in Canada is trying to learn Norwegian. Well, let me tell you, Norwegian, Danish, and Swedish are all mutually intelligible languages, meaning they all overlap with one another. So if you're speaking Norwegian, Swedish, and Danish speakers will understand most of what you're saying. Obviously, there are different like grammar rules and different words for different things, but like it's like 70 to 80% similar to each other. Out of those three, Norwegian is the easiest one to learn and is the most mutually intelligible, meaning more Danish and Swedish speakers will understand Norwegian rather than the other two languages, if that makes sense. So that's why I'm learning Norwegian. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up. If you loved it, hit that subscribe button and ring that bell for notification. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.